Let's take one example on periodic and aperiodic signals. Determine whether or not each of following signal is periodic or aperiodic. If periodic, find its fundamental period. Here one signal is given, that is x of t is equal to cos phi. We supposed to verify whether it is periodic signal or aperiodic signal. If it is periodic, we supposed to calculate fundamental period also. So here x of t is equal to cos phi u pi t. It's a continuous time signal, and we know that for continuous time signal, the signal to be periodic, if it satisfies a condition x of t is equal to x of t plus. So anyhow, here x of t is cos phi u pi t. Now we'll try to calculate x of t plus t. It should be equal to x of t. If that is the case, then this signal is periodic. Now I will find x of t plus t. Therefore, x of t plus t is equal to x of t plus t is obtained by replacing. Therefore, x of t plus t is equal to cos phi u pi t is replaced by t plus t. I'll simplify this. Cos phi u pi t plus phi u pi into t. So in this signal, we know that this is the omega. Therefore, we can write omega is equal to phi u pi, where omega can be represented as 2 pi f is equal to phi u pi, or I can write it as f is equal to phi u pi divided by 2 pi, which is equal to phi u by 2. So this f is fundamental frequency, that is phi u by 2. Therefore, t is equal to 1 by f, which is nothing but 2 by phi u. So this t is nothing but fundamental period. So therefore, now I can write x of t plus t as x of t plus t is equal to cos phi u pi t plus phi u pi into t is nothing but 2 by phi u, or I can simplify this as x of t plus t is equal to cos of phi u pi t plus phi u will get cancelled, will get 2 pi. So therefore I can write it as x of t plus t is equal to, that is we know that cos theta plus 2 pi is nothing but cos theta. Therefore, cos phi u pi t plus 2 pi is nothing but cos phi u pi t. So here we can observe, let this be equation number 1, let this be equation number 2. So from equation 1 and 2, it is verified that x of t is equal to x of, therefore, x of t is periodic with period, that is 2 by phi u. Let's consider another example. The given signal is x of t is equal to sin phi u t. So we know that the condition for periodicity is x of t is equal to x of t plus t. So here first we'll calculate t, that is in this example it is of sin omega t. Therefore here omega is equal to phi u. So omega is nothing but 2 pi f is equal to phi u. Therefore f is equal to phi u by 2 pi. So therefore, t is equal to 1 by f is equal to 2 pi divided by phi u. So now I will write x of t plus t, that is x of t plus t is equal to, that is sin phi u t plus t will simplify. This will be sin phi u t plus phi u capital T, or I can write it as sin phi u t plus phi u into 2 pi by phi u, because t value is 2 pi by phi u. Therefore, I can simplify this further as sin phi u t plus 2 pi, that is x of t plus t. So, we know that sin theta plus 2 pi is nothing but sin theta. Therefore, x of t plus t is equal to sin phi u t. Therefore, we will call it as equation number 1, this as 2. So, from 1 and 2, we can say that x of t is equal to, from 1 and 2, x of t is equal to x of t plus t. Therefore, x of t is periodic with period 2 pi by phi u. Now consider another example. X of t is equal to cos square 2 pi t. We'll try to simplify this first. We know that cos square theta is equal to 1 plus cos 2 theta divided by 2. So now we'll try to express the same expression in this form. That is, therefore, x of t is equal to, here cos square theta, 2 pi t is theta, that is 1 plus cos 2 into 2 pi, that is nothing but 4 pi t divided by 2. So here we can observe 1 by 2 is a constant. Next we have 1 by 2 cos 4 pi t. So we have to consider only cos 4 pi t term, or I can write it as x of t is equal to 1 by 2 plus 1 by 2 cos. Here we can observe that omega value is 2 pi, that is cos omega t. Therefore here omega is equal to 4 pi. Omega is nothing but angular frequency, which can be represented as 2 pi f equal to 4 pi. Therefore, f equal to 4 pi by 2 pi, which is equal to 2. Therefore, we can write t is equal to 1 by 2, which is nothing but 0.5 seconds. X of t plus t is equal to I'll consider the same this one 1 by 2 plus 1 by 2 cos 4 pi t plus t, or I can write it as 1 by 2 plus 1 by 2 cos 4 pi t plus 4 pi into capital T, which can be written as 1 by 2 plus 1 by 2 cos of 4 pi t plus 4 pi into t is 1 by 2. Therefore, I can write it as 1 by 2 plus 1 by 2 cos 4 pi t plus 2 pi. So here cos 4 pi t plus 2 pi is nothing but cos 4 pi t. We can say that the signal is periodic. Therefore, x of t is periodic. So this is fundamental period. and x of t is periodic. Let's consider one more example. X of t is equal to e power j pi t. X of t is equal to e power j pi t. We'll verify whether it is a periodic signal or aperiodic signal. Here, compare this with e power j omega t. Therefore, we can write omega is equal to pi here. Therefore, omega is nothing but 2 pi f equal to pi. Therefore, f equal to 1 by 2. So, therefore, t is equal to 2 seconds. This t is fundamental period. Now, we will try to calculate x of t plus t to check the periodicity. Let's check periodicity. X of t plus t is equal to e power j pi. Now I suppose to replace this t by t plus t, that is t plus t. Therefore I can write it as e power j pi t plus t value is 2, or I can write it as e power j pi t into e power j 2 pi. Here I can write e power j theta is represented as cos theta plus j sin theta. Therefore, this can be represented as cos 2 pi plus j sin 2 pi. We know that cos 2 pi value is 1, sin 2 pi is 0. That is, so this entire value is 1. Therefore, e power j 2 pi is equal to 1. Therefore, x of t plus t is equal to e power j pi t into 1. So therefore, x of t, that is e power j pi t, is equal to x of t plus t, that is e power j pi t. Therefore, x of t is periodic signal with period, that is 2 seconds. Now let's consider another example. Let's verify whether it is periodic or aperiodic. X of t is equal to 3 plus t square. So we can write it. Now we'll find x of t plus t. X of t plus t is obtained by replacing t by t plus t. I can write it as 3 plus t whole square. Or I can write it as 3 plus t square plus t square plus 2t into t. So here we can observe x of t plus t is equal to 3 plus t square plus t square plus 2t. So if it is only 3 plus t square, then x of t plus t will be equal to x of t. But here we have two more terms, that is t square plus 2tt. Therefore, x of t plus t is not equal to x of t. Therefore, x of t is non-periodic signal. Now we'll consider another example. X of t is equal to e power sin t. So now let's calculate x of t plus t, which is equal to e power sin t plus t. It can be represented as, so here omega is equal to, that is sin omega t, omega is equal to 1. Therefore 2 pi f equal to 1. Therefore, f equal to 1 upon 2 pi, which is nothing but t is equal to 2 pi. So therefore, I can write x of t plus t is equal to e power sine t plus t is nothing but 2 pi, which is nothing but sine t plus 2 pi is nothing but sine t, e power sine t, which is equal to x of t. Therefore, x of t is periodic with period 2 pi. We'll consider another example. So we calculate first x of t plus t, which is equal to e power a t plus t. It can be represented as e power a t dot e power a into t. So here we can observe that x of t plus t will be equal to x of t if a or t is equal to 0. That is, at that time this entire term will become 1. Therefore, this is not equal to x of t. Therefore, x of t is aperiodic or non-periodic signal. So this will be periodic only if either a equal to 0 or t equal to 0. In that case, this entire term will become 1. Then x of t plus t will be equal to e power a t. Thank you for watching.